I got a story for you, which I personally find kind of funny, but at the end of it, I'm gonna need your help with something, so please stick around. July of 2016, I decided I wanted to stop dating Alicia and marry her. Spoiler alert, it worked out. I knew she liked Tangled, so I thought I'd get my Flynn Rider on and surprise her with a magical evening with floating lanterns. Yeah, like that, but better. I got the ring, laid out the plans, and when the floating lanterns I ordered finally came to my house, I gave Alicia a call asking her to hang out. I very casually said, hey, maybe we should go up to the mountains. I hear there's a pretty good view up there. And she went for it. When we got there, the stars were just starting to come out, the city lights were coming on, and oh, it was beautiful, it was beautiful. So after we got all cozy, I very nonchalantly said,
hey, you know, I got a floating lantern in my back pocket. You wanna go set it on fire?
Foreshadowing. Just as we got one open, the wind kicked up, and being in Utah during the middle of the summer, unless I wanted to set the whole mountainside on fire, this was gonna be a bad idea.
So I very smoothly said, hey, no big deal, but maybe we should drive 30 minutes to go to the lake where it'll be less windy.
So after a very comfortable ride to the lake, we found out it was closed because apparently algae can turn the water toxic. We found a dark section of road, got the lantern out, lit the candle, and just as it was filling up with warm air, the wind picked up and set the thing on fire. The floating lantern, which I had delayed my plans for over a week, had set on fire and I had to literally stomp the flames out. Brooding on the side of the road and Alicia politely trying not to laugh, I not so quietly let out two words. Screw it! I grabbed my bag, got on one knee, and proposed to Alicia in a place so dark she couldn't even see the ring.
How could the woman say no?
My surprise failed, my lantern failed, and if I had been a little bit more prideful, my evening would have failed. But those two words, screw it, taught me a very important lesson that day, and that is, do not let less important details get in the way of what it is you want to do.
And if those details literally go up in flames, you literally have to stomp them out.
Now, this is the point where I want your help. Chances are, in the tens of people who watch my vlog, there are some people who really embrace this principle and some who really would like to but struggle with it. I want to have a conversation about this. When is it good to adopt this principle? When is it not? What experiences have you had as you have boiled down what it is you truly want to one thing and then said, screw it, to all of the unimportant details which have gotten in your way? Knowing you guys, I think we're just gonna have a ball hashing this out in the comment section down below. And if you have a dream or a goal or anything that's been haunting the back of your mind for a while, I hope you find the courage and tenacity to just screw it. Wait.